So here's how we could define factorial. And we should go back to our mathematical definition. That's what we want to turn into code. We had our base case where factorial is 0, the result should be 1. And we had a recursive case where the input is greater than 0, we want to have the result be n times factorial of n minus 1. So we can turn that fairly straightforwardly into code. So here's the code. We're going to define a procedure. Just like the previous definition, we have one input, it's a number, we'll call it n. Now we need to have the code. So we need to first check if we've reached the base case. So we'll use an if for that. And we're going to check if n is equal to 0. Remember, we need the double equals for the comparison. That means we've reached the base case, and we defined the value of factorial of 0 is defined as 1. So that means when n equals 0, what we should do is return the value 1. When n is not equal to 0, we'll use else for the case where n is not equal to 0. Well, then we have the recursive case, and that was given by the definition that the factorial of n for numbers greater than 0 is equal to n times factorial of n minus 1. So that's exactly what we want to do in the Python code. We'll return the new result, which is n times the result we get, calling factorial, passing in n minus 1. And this may seem strange that we're defining factorial using factorial. It seems like that's kind of circular. But the reason that it's not circular is because we have this base case, that we have a case where we do stop. We stop once we reach the case where n is equal to 0. And because every time we call factorial, instead of passing in the same value of n that we started with, we're passing in n minus 1. It's getting smaller. Eventually, we're going to get to 0, assuming that we started with n as some positive whole number. So we eventually stop, return 1. And on the way there, we're going to be multiplying in all these values. So let's step through what happens when we run this code. So let's look at an example. Suppose we called factorial passing in 3. So that means we're going to enter the procedure here. The value that n refers to is going to be 3 inside the body of factorial. We're going to try the comparison. N is not equal to 0, so we don't return 1. So we're going to go to the else. And that means we're going to return the value of n times factorial of n minus 1. So that means we're computing the value of n times factorial of n and n minus 1. Well, n was 3, so n minus 1 is 2. That's what happened as a result of the first call. But we're not done, right? We still need to evaluate this. So now we're evaluating factorial of 2. That means we're entering factorial again. This time the value of n will refer to 2. We do the comparison. N is not equal to 0, so we go to the else clause. Now we're going to return the result of n times factorial of n minus 1. In this case, the value of n is 2. So the value of factorial of 2 will be 2 times the result we get by calling factorial, passing in the value of n minus 1, so calling factorial passing in 1. And remember, that was part of the return where we had 3 times factorial 2. So we still have the 3 times, but now we're getting the result of factorial 2. It's 2 times something. We're calling factorial again. We still don't know what factorial of 1 is. So that means we're going to re-enter factorial. We finished here. We're doing the call. We're going to re-enter factorial, but this time the value of n now refers to 1. And now, again, this test is false. So we go to the else clause, and now we're going to return n, which is 1, times the result of factorial 0. So now we're calling factorial 0. We're going back into the procedure. Now the value of n refers to is 0. And now this test is actually true. N equals 0. So we'll go to the return here. We return 1. That means the result of factorial 0 is 1. So to get the result of factorial 1, we had 1 times factorial 0. That's 1 times 1, which is 1. And now to get the result back from factorial 2, we had 2 times factorial 1, which we now know as 1. So we're going to have the result here as 2. And to get the result for factorial 3, we had 3 times factorial 2, which we now has the value 2. We'll get the result is 6. And note the way we've defined it. Well, if we tried instead factorial 4, if we started with factorial 4, what would have happened is the first time we go through, we get 4 times factorial 3. So factorial 4 would be 4 times factorial 3. Well, we had factorial 3 is 6. 4 times 6 would give us 24, which is the result of factorial 4.